So what node functions do we have available? Basically, we have two bipolar VCAs, which are DC coupled. So you can use them for audio signals, but you can also use them for modulation signals. So you can use a low frequency oscillator signal to modulate another low frequency signal or envelope signal. We have a gain pot that will crank up a signal by plus 20 dB. If it's turned to the left, you have unity gain, so the same signal strength. If you go to the right, you got plus 20 dB. And the idea for that is that if you plug in a line level signal from like maybe a drum computer or effect machine, then mostly the line level is much lower than the signal levels that are used in modular synthesizers. And you can crank it up to modular synthesizer level to feed it into the filter without having the filter create much noise. We have an offset pot, and the offset pot just adds or subtracts a fixed voltage to a signal, which is basically what you would like to do with, for instance, a signal that modulates a frequency or something. So if I quickly patch something else. Oops, here you go. For instance, if I want to modulate the pitch of an oscillator, I could do it like this. And we listen to the output of the oscillator like this. Now, what you would do with the offset pot is that if I get this plug out and I plug in a stereo cable in the offset, you can use it for that purpose. We have two audio taper pots, and we have a node quantizer. And the node quantizer is, of course, meant to force all the frequencies into a certain musical scale, if you really insist on playing in a certain musical scale. The way how to use the quantizer is basically the same as any other thing. Like, for instance, let's put some different colors of cable. So if we listen to the oscillator, and here I have an LFO signal, and I want to sort of let it modulate the oscillator in a musical scale, then I just connect this into the 1 volt octave input and connect the stereo cable between the quantizer processor and this particular node. Now, why this particular node with the white thing? That is because this node is a node that has a very high precision resistors used, so it won't affect the scale and the detuning in the buffer amplifiers and keep everything in tune. Now, if I choose the most left scale and I start to open this knob, it quantizes the input signal. It's a real-time quantizer. And this is a half note scale, so meaning all the white and black keys on the keyboard. Here we got a basically the white keys, and we got a couple of minor and major scales. And the last two scales, of course, if you buy a system, you get on a piece of paper which scales are there. I don't have them in my head the right order right now. But the last two scales are special because they are not meant to produce musical scales, but they're actually used as wave shapers on audio waves or LFO waves.
You can make some digital wavetable kind of curves with your analog oscillator.
So, yeah, the way it works is quite simple. You sort of like, for instance, let's listen to the output of the quantizer and use audio wave as input. So I just put it now in the output of oscillator, and we just, I think it's a good idea to actually attenuate the output. So we don't overload everything. So, basically, it's a real-time quantizer working at about 14 kilohertz and with a resolution of 8 bits, so you will have some digital artifacts present in the sound, but it's also a little bit the charm of the thing. Basically, the waveforms that are created are a bit like FM waveforms. But the modulation depth can be bigger than the output that this oscillator can provide. So it is actually a good idea to amplify the input a little bit and also add a little bit of offset to it, and then we can sort of go into some deeper ranges and make better use of the total range that it can have. Interesting thing is that this effect is dependent on the amplitude of the input signal, in this system you can already control at the oscillator level, that now I can sort of modulate the amplitude of the oscillator and
you can
And with the other wavetable. Of course, a very interesting effect is if you have this particular kind of sound that you can use it, which is basically caused by the oscillator. Then it is sort of processed by this wave shaper, and then of course you can use the output of the wave shaper to modulate, sort of feedback modulate something in the oscillator. Like for instance, I can now take the output signal that comes from the quantizer, put it in the pitch modulation signal of the oscillator, and sort of and go to really weird stuff.
Wow.